Hey, what's up? It's Dustin Phelps with FormAssembly, and I'm going to show you how to build your first web form. Now, if you want to follow along, you can start a free trial of FormAssembly by clicking the link in the description below. All right, let's get started. Once you sign in, you'll be greeted with the Forms List page, which will list all of the forms you've built. Assuming you've never built a form before, this page will most likely be blank. From here, click on the Add New Form button in the left side menu, and it will open up a box giving you four options for building your form. You can start with a blank form, which, as it sounds, means that you'll be building a form from scratch. You can use a template from our template library, which gets you started with recommended fields and settings. You can also use the Salesforce import tool to build a form that uses your Salesforce objects and fields as a template, but we'll cover that in another tutorial. Or you can clone an existing form, which is useful if you're planning to build a form that is similar to one you've already built before. For this tutorial, we'll start with a blank form. Now we're in the form builder. For this tutorial, we're going to build a simple contact form, which is useful when you need to collect information from website visitors. But before we get too far along, let's give our form a title by clicking on the title placeholder text and giving it the name Reach Out. Next, click Save. This title can be whatever makes the most sense for you. Most contact forms ask to collect some basic information like first and last name and email address. Sometimes a message field is added to allow your respondents to provide more details. Let's add these fields by going over to the Add Content menu and hovering over Questions. You can see there are a lot of different options here for question types, such as checkboxes, drop-down menus, and file uploads. But the one we want here is the Text Input field. Just click and drag and drop the field into the form. You can also just click on the field to add it to the form. This method will add the field to the bottom of the form, whereas the drag and drop method allows you more precision on where the field is being placed. Now, I know I need three text input fields, one for first name, last name, and email address, so I'll click on the text input field one more time. To change the field labels, just click on the label and type out the name of the field. Now let's add a message box by going back to the Add Content menu and selecting the Text Area field, and then change the label. To make this form even more useful, you can add a validation rule to your email field, making it so that people can only enter email addresses into this field. This is important because quality data in your form translates to a cleaner CRM. We can do this by selecting the email field, clicking Options, and navigating to Validations. Now, we'll set the expected input format to email. Let's also make this a required field so that the person filling out the form can't submit the form without entering their email address. We can do this by simply clicking the Required button in the Field toolbar. The last thing we'll do in the form builder is customize the text on our submit button by clicking on the button and changing the text to contact us. Now click save in the upper right hand side of the window and then view your completed form by clicking the view icon in the left sidebar. And there you go, you just built your first web form in FormAssembly. To learn more about what you can do in our powerful platform, you can watch more of our videos about things like form customization, connecting to Salesforce, and more. And if you like this video, please give us a thumbs up and be sure to crush that subscribe button to stay updated when we release a new video. Thanks for watching, and as always, happy form building.